A new blood test could catch ovarian cancer in its earliest and most treatable stage, according to a new study. The new method was devised by researcher Karen Liu at the University of Texas's MD Anderson Cancer Center in Houston. She examined the potential of a two-stage ovarian cancer screening. The blood test, looking for a change the tumor-marking blood protein, CA125, followed by a transvaginal ultrasound. Health Day reports that unlike breast, cervical, or colon cancer, there's no reliable screen test to detect the disease. They call it a silent killer. By the time a woman knows she has it, the cancer's often advanced and the outlook grim. Her team monitored more than 4,000 postmenopausal women over an 11-year period, with all subjects receiving an annual CA125 blood test. They noticed that on an average, nearly 5.8% of women were detected with immediate risk each year. Based on the ultrasound exams, 10 women underwent surgery, 4 had invasive ovarian cancer, 2 had malignant ovarian tumors, 1 suffered endometrial cancer, and 3 had benign ovarian tumors. And while the results are being considered groundbreaking, Liu doesn't think they're practice-changing just yet, writing in a statement, "However, our findings suggest that using a longitudinal or change-over-time screening strategy may be beneficial in postmenopausal women with an average risk of developing ovarian cancer." The trial results are being published in Cancer, the Journal of the American Cancer Society, and Liu says she believes the finding will raise hopes that were dashed by a similar, earlier study that deemed the screening unsuccessful. According to the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, each year about 20,000 U.S. women are diagnosed with ovarian cancer. It's the 8th most common cancer and the 5th leading cause of cancer death among U.S. women. And the National Cancer Institute estimates there will be more than 22,000 new cases of ovarian cancer in the U.S. this year, resulting in more than 14,000 deaths. It's unknown whether the findings could be applied to younger women, but the method is undergoing additional testing in the U.K. That study will involve 300,000 women and is due to report in 2015. For Newsy, I'm Megan Murphy.